Okay. Thank you so much for help for calling me. It's very my pleasure to be here, basically to be home, because the electronic department is my home. I work for General Motors, so I'm basically here, not on a long trip. And made my PhD a lot of years ago. It's sad to say this, but it's okay. Okay, basically this is my contact. If you need to talk with me, if you like some question that today are not you're not okay, you can write me. I'm here. We can have a chat, have a coffee. For sure, it will be a pleasure for me. And basically my education. So I graduated in electronic engineer, and then I started my PhD in metrology with Professor Marco Parvis. Here in the electronic department, so I focus my PhD on electronic measurement. I will spend few words talking about my PhD and then my professional career outside Politecnico. Maybe it could be, I don't know, more interesting for you. You are all PhD guys, or you are almost? Okay. Okay. Maybe it could be interesting for you to understand what a PhD student can do in the basically in the job after the PhD graduation. So I worked here for 3 years as a PhD student, and my first and main development study is an innovative low-cost sensor based on optical technology. Basically, our goal was to develop a smart and low-cost sensor with a very high sensitivity to gas for cultural heritage, let me say, ambient, because in this kind of ambient there is some pollutants can be very dangerous for people and also for the showcases. So we developed this sensor. This is a prototype. There is the plastic optical fiber sensor that has been developed by us. That is modified and built by me and another colleague that today is not here. And then also the electronic part has been developed in collaboration with another guys. So we developed a few prototypes and we tested, and I was involved both in the electronic and also in the sensing part, and also in the metrological catalyzation of the sensor. I faced also different metrological problems. I remember different kind of setup measurement we built during my PhD for different applications. I remember the energy management system, data acquisition for the photovoltaic panels in order to test different kind of panels in Alba with the Ferrero industry. So I faced a different topic related to metrology and metrological system. Then after my PhD, I did a completely different job. Always related to testing, but not to chemical or something more specific, basically. I was hired from a small industry, Spanini, that is an industry in Torino city center that work today also in the financial document digitalization. There is a small picture and the website if you're interested. And I was an R&D testing engineer. So for sure I was working with testing, so my metrological background was very helpful for me. Because my job was to develop software and hardware tools for testing product in series and also for the prototyping. I also, since there was no laboratory when I arrived in Panini, I also was the coordinator of the building of the metrological laboratory, which was very interesting because it was the very first time someone in Panini had the chance to develop a new lab, a new structure, so the budget, everything. It was very interesting for me. And also I was the coordinator of a project called Fondo Impresa that was, let me say, a project in order to train the people in Panini with some knowledge, technical knowledge. We performed some courses from Politecnico di Torino professor to Panini in order to teach some metrological know-how, how to deal with the acquisition system and something like that. After 2 years in Panini, I was hired from GM, so I'm in GM since many years until now. GM is a car maker, so just to remember it is a very big, big company working with cars, it's a car maker. And what we do here in Torino? because in Torino there is a global research and development center, basically on diesel side, so specifically for diesel globally. When we talk about diesel, we talk about Torino, because Torino has the global responsibility all around the world for the GM. We work for North America, South America, and also Asia, and different market, minor market. These are our responsibilities, so we are responsibility of developing diesel engine from the scratch to the production. Diesel controls, because GM is the only one car maker that's built its own diesel controls also. And also the ASIC, because GM is also involving in design and production of the ASIC. Basically, I work in this area, so diesel controls area. Oops. There is a lot of people here, so it's strange to say, but we are a very good number, very young, and also GM is very interested in hiring PhD, because the experience and the mindset of a PhD guy is very appreciated in GM. So it's let me say, it's a plus if you have a PhD and you make an interview in GM. Good news. There is a lot of lab in GM here in the ground floor. So as let me say, metrological PhD, there is a lot of work to do. In effect, I started working on a testing engineer also in GM. I worked on testing the hardware module and the firmware module of the ECU, the engine control module. And also I developed a new system, hardware and software, to test the ECU during the phase of the development, so starting from the beginning to the production. Then I cover a different role, it is technology system engineer. Basically, it's a kind of R&D that take some project, new project, and try to understand if this project can be put in production or not. So there is a 2-3 year project with an experimental phase, the analytics phase, coordination, management, a lot of stuff related to this project in order to understand if a specific technique of controls or other topics can be used in production or not. In the last year, I worked on advanced and predictive diagnosis. Today, I'm a big data control system engineer, and you will understand why here, because today, the connectivity, the electronic part of a vehicle is, let me say, the most important. So the vehicles are connected. You can buy every car, you have a connection system. The one developed by GM is called OnStar, and allow to have your car connected to a lot of service and function, but also allow engineering us to have data from the field, a lot of data from a lot of car in the field. So the new, let me say, challenge from us is use this kind of data, how the driver is driving and something like that, to understand how our product are working on the field, if we can do better, and where and how. So basically, the new acquisition system is not only a lab. For sure, the experimental part in the lab is fundamental, but also the field, the monitoring of the connected cars for us is our new challenge. Million vehicles, million, a lot of data. So basically, we are in the big data area. So we are collaborating till now in my department with the Politecnico, in particular with the Professor Elena Baralis. So we are always working in the, let me say, in the research part, because we want to understand which techniques are suitable for the our business to be used from understand from all this data some valuable information. So basically, this is my very brief introduction. If you have some questions, I think will be more interesting for you, just to understand, I don't know, everything you want from PhD to, let me say, to industry, how does it work?